The basics of effective icon design are clear. Icons need to be consistent, legible, and clear so that users can easily understand and recognize them. Hi, my name is Niki, and welcome to this video where we're going to talk about how to design better icons. Iconography is an important part of user interface design. It's a visual language that represents content and actions, as well as it shows the meaning behind functionality. So here are some tips to help you design better icons. Grid icons are made using grids. So first, what you want to do is you need to define your bounding box, and you got to define a safe zone within your bounding box and set a few key lines. So you got to use the grid as a template to make your icon's proportion uniform. Don't mix the size, rather stick to the same size. For example, stick to 24 pixel or 16 pixel. I like to use these two. Also, if an icon is narrow, don't be afraid of rotating the icon so it fills the container or the grid, and try to use the whole container. Your icon will look more balanced that way. Use consistent design. A few things to keep in mind when it comes to consistency. You gotta use the same line width or stroke width, corner radius, and fill style to make your icons unified so that they look like they come from the same icon family. For example, thickness, I like to use 2 pixel, and a corner radius, I like to use an odd number, either 3 pixel or 5 pixel. It's up to you, but try to use the same corner radius. And you might wonder, should you mix filled and outline style? And the answer is, it depends. Usually, you shouldn't. However, if you want to represent a different state of an icon, then feel free to mix them. But be aware of, all of your icons need to have a nice filled match as well. Part of becoming a great designer is learning and knowing when to break the rules and when to follow them. It comes with time and practice. Trust me on this. The next one is use a minimalistic style. Less is usually more when it comes to icons, so try to avoid intrinsic icon design on the web. Use only details that are important to make the icon easy to recognize and be understood. Also, all of your icons in your icon set should use the same color combinations. So choose your colors and stick to them. Sure, sometimes you need to make an exception here and there, but try to stick to your colors. I would never use more than 3 colors for my icons. I really like monochrome icons, but this is just a personal preference. Usually for an action icon or an icon button, I like to use only one color. I represent the state with a different color, if that makes sense. But if your icon is more of like a graphic on a website, you have more wiggle room there. So feel free to use more colors there, but I wouldn't go over 5 colors. That should be your maximum number of colors that you use on an icon. So the next one is spacing. You gotta use the same spacing between icon elements, for example, 3 pixel. It will unify and harmonize your icons. Next one is using optical correction. Sometimes when you have different shapes nested in each other, your icon can look off balance visually. If that's the case, align the elements based on the optical center to balance them. The YouTube logo mark is a perfect example of it, where the triangle is not exactly in the center. Just take a look. When it comes to icon design, we need to prioritize recognition over cohesiveness, because recognition and clarity distinguish a great icon set from an okay icon set. So never sacrifice on clarity. Of course, icons should be aesthetic as well. However, icons should convey the message first, and then they should look attractive. Creating unified icon set is actually far more difficult than it appears, because you need to pay attention to the smallest details, and you probably need to go back and redesign your icons multiple times. I remember I spent so much time with icon design when I started out as a designer, but that was a long time ago. So if you're looking for handy resources, then make sure you check out the description box, because I linked a few of them there. Also, if you would like to learn about how to design the perfect icons and icon sets, because maybe this is something that really interests you, then I would recommend the Icon Handbook. It's definitely worth the money. I really hope you got something out of this video. As always, thank you so much for hanging out with me, and I see you next time. Bye.